Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IS. This is 20th lecture of Science and Tech Value Addition Series with Dr. Vivek Rana, and the theme for this 20th lecture is Budget 2020. I'll be discussing the allocation to the science sector and what are the major highlights of this year's budget, because this is the time when economic survey and budget are the themes on which students are investing their energy. So I'll be doing my section of science and tech around it. So what is budget promising this year is the theme for today's lecture. Is it incremental increase or it's drastic increase, or the scientific fraternity is disappointed? We're going to be discussing all these themes. So first of all, what exactly as a general studies student you should cover from the science section of that budget 2020? First of all, we have to understand what has been the allocation to different departments which are working for the science and tech sector. In our introductory lecture in science and tech, we had discussed how different sectors contribute to the socio-economic development. So hopes were high this year whether there will be more allocation or not, and government has not disappointed. Almost all major departments have seen increase, and in most of the sectors it's more than 5%, which is a positive step. I will be going into details of the percentage wise, because you don't have to memorize the exact 1000 crore allocated, 2816 allocated. Those numerical values are not important, but the trend is to be covered. So first of all, the main department which is spearheading science and tech is the Department of Science and Tech under Ministry of Science and Technologies. And there are three departments which are working under Ministry of Science and Tech. There is Department of Science and Technology, there is DSIR, Department of Scientific and Industrial Research, and then there is Department of Biotechnology, which is making lot of contribution in pharmaceutical, agriculture and industrial sector. So overall, this Department of Science and Tech is the one which is shining throughout and has been allocated the maximum 13% jump from the last year. And biotech, which is really spearheading the genome project as well as gene landscaping project, has been also seen increase of 8%. And nevertheless, the Ministry of Earth Sciences, which looks after oceanic research and earth development, has also seen an increase of 8%. And the Department of Space, on which we are resting for major mission this year, has once again seen a boost of 8%. And we all know how Gaganyaan has been already allocated being 10,000 crore. So finally, the science sector is getting the funds which is required. Yes, on a critical note, we can say that it's still a long way if we want to match the developed countries like China and US, which are allocating even more sum, considering the sum of their economy. But still, overall, the allocation has seen an upward trend this year. And hopefully, this should continue in the coming years as well. Because we know that science and if you are investing in science and tech, you are not investing in just particular sector. You are investing for future generation and for socio-economic development as well. Also, our research and development has mainly been revolving around application-oriented research. So there's no harm in investing this sum. Our Science and Tech Policy 2013 had promised that we will be jumping around 2%, and we are slowly inching towards that thing. Now, the main highlight for which has been dominating in headlines in Budget 2020 in Science and Tech is the major sum allocated under Department of Science and Tech. Almost 8,000 crore has been promised for national mission on quantum computing and application. So this, make sure you are familiar with the Quest program, because this is what is preparing the ground for this national mission on quantum computing and application. So even though it's a risky investment to make, because if you are following current affairs, you must have heard lot of articles regarding quantum supremacy, quantum winter. So because this is one of the technologies which does not have a direct research and development, that it will result in the one which you are aiming for, but it's worth to invest, because this is the future of computing as well as other applications. So India has gone ahead. It doesn't want to play a second fiddle anymore, because over the years, we have seen whenever some new theme is there, we generally take it for granted or do not push in the right spirit, and eventually we become dependent on Western countries. So this time we are trying to develop our own quantum applications and missions, and this is a major takeaway from this year's budget. So I'll be discussing in the next slide what this quantum computing is up in brief. And then the another key highlight of this year's budget is once again we are targeting one of the dreaded disease which is causing large case casualties over the years, tuberculosis. We have seen how this tuberculosis madness has aggravated to MDR, TB, multi-drug resistant tuberculosis. So this year, we once again we have reiterated our pledge that by 2025 we are going to eliminate tuberculosis. Yes, it's going to be logically and logistically difficult to eliminate, but once we set the higher target, we tend to get closer to the target. Even National Health Policy 2017, which was out, had this theme, and in a couple of years back also this budget when diseases were announced, this was. So once again we are pushing towards TB elimination. So you should ideally brush up your facts regarding the tuberculosis, which I will do in the next slide. So what are quantum computing? Let's have just a brief overview. Now, unlike the classical computers which works in bits 0 or 1, quantum communication or quantum computing it will revolve around quantum bits. Qubits is the term they generally use. Unlike 0 and 1, there is a superimposition and there are multiple permutation combinations possible, which makes the classical computers, the supercomputers even, which we are seeing today, will be totally outdated once quantum computing comes into place. Because the calculations which it is taking thousands of years for supercomputer would be done in fraction of seconds. So almost all supercomputing would become obsolete once this quantum computing comes into play in real terms. So this is quantum, and this quantum computing will have a numerous application. It will not only be used for complex mathematical calculations, it will have a role in cryptography, it will be used for quantum communication, like in China, MISIUS is the satellite which was developed a couple of years back, which is touted as the first hack-proof satellite of the world. So if you want to take communications and make it hack-proof, then quantum communication holds the solution to it. Also, some next generation scientific algorithms can be designed, and next wave of scientific revolution is likely to be triggered by this quantum computing. So this is worth project in whichever countries are currently investing. Once again, China and US are leading the fray, and now the QUEST program, because we started this in 2017. QUEST stands for Quantum Enabled Science and Technology. This is an ambitious project, and it is getting the required support from the policy makers. In 2019 itself, in January, we had the first ever meeting in IIT Hyderabad, and the further roadmap has been designed. So this budget is a supplement effort, and finally a national mission of the scale of quantum computing would be now launched in full-fledged manner. And already BharatNet program has been allocated 6,000 crores, and that's another takeaway from this year's budget, because we are trying to connect almost 1 lakh gram panchayat with the optical fiber. So make sure BharatNet, quantum communication, basics, you are absolutely clear with it. Now coming to the tuberculosis, once again we have to understand it's a contagious infectious disease caused by bacteria, Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And the system which is commonly affected is the respiratory system. Pulmonary tuberculosis is the one you have to cover in your general studies section. And then you have to understand that there is a vaccine available, BCG, Bacillus Calmette-Guérin. The treatment is DOTS, directly observed treatment short course, in which rifampicin is the first line of drug. And currently the gene export test has been developed for quick diagnosis. And to tackle madness of MDR-TB, bidaquiline is the drug of choice. So these are some of the basic themes which you should revise, because it's a communicable disease, transmits by droplet infection just like coronavirus. So that's why it's a community hazard. Even though a lot of efforts have been made, there is a TB elimination program going on, there is a various government awareness campaigns, multiple role ambassadors have been appointed, and finally this is no longer in the top 3 diseases which causes fatality in India. but still it's among top 10. So a lot more needs to be done. March 24 is celebrated as National Tuberculosis Day to spread awareness, because that's the time where more articles are likely to come. So we are heading towards March, so you will see, since it's announced in budget, a lot of more articles, and any new developments regarding vaccinations, you must go through it, or some new campaign which is being decided. Apart from that, you could revise another upcoming space missions, because since substantial allocation has been made to space sector, and we all know this mid-2020 is going to be dominated by Aditya L1 mission. I've already discussed the specifics of that theme in one of my lectures. And then Gaganyaan, just like Vyomitra dominated headlines, is continuing to garner the attention it desires. And there are a long list of communication as well as remote sensing missions which have been planned for 2020. So you will see once again the space sector rising to the occasion and meeting the aspirations of our country. So this is what budget has revolved around. There is no specific chapter on economic survey on science this time. Unlike in 2018-19, there were separate chapters in which achievements of Indian scientists were highlighted as well as the upcoming mission. But this year, there is no specific chapter, so you just have to focus on these qualitative themes. If examiner wants to pick a question from this sector, then quantum communication, tuberculosis, as well as BharatNet, these are the popular themes on which questions can be framed. And finally, let's have a practice question on the theme. So I picked the diseases part because diseases are in news and coronavirus is just dominating headlines. It's already surpassed the SARS in number of cases. Yes, the fatality rate is still less, but still we should be, it has put all countries in, on its toes. So I have just framed a basic question about the positive agent, and we have to just pick the correctly matched pair. So tuberculosis, I have just discussed, is caused by bacteria. So first option is wrong. It's caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis, to be precise. MERS, just like SARS, is dominating headline. It stands for Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. It's one of the dreaded disease which was caused by a corona group of family of viruses, and it caused a lot of scare in Middle East countries. Yes, in South Korea as well, a couple of cases were detected. So this is once again a viral disease. It's caused by coronavirus family. And then measles is the one you have to pick. It's caused by virus only, measles, because these are the, these measles, mumps, German measles, all are viral diseases which we had covered in our class lecture. So C is the right one. And malaria, we all know, is caused by a protozoa. Plasmodium is the species, to be precise. Plasmodium, falciparum, vivax, ovale, what not. So these are the, yes, the transmitting agent is the female Anopheles mosquito, but causative agent is protozoa. Okay. So this is what we had in today's lecture, in the 20th one of Science and Tech Value Addition series. Keep following for more updates. I hope today's session was useful. I will be back soon with another Science and Tech. Thank you very much.